Live from Fargo and serving you on TV, online, and on the go. This is Valley News Live at 6.
When I saw the same name and I was like, oh my gosh, is this really going on? Did it really just happen to me too?
A Moorhead man reacting to a whistleblower investigation from last week when a couple warned about buying cats from a woman on Facebook.
The man claims the same scam happened to him, saying he was told he was buying a Maine Coon kitten, but it turns out it was a barn cat with a laundry list of medical problems that weren't disclosed to him.
Valley News Team's crime and safety reporter Bailey Hurley talked with the man who claims he's another feline fraud victim.
Just a few days into being a new pet parent, Justin Gullickson thought it was over for his new kitten, Lenny.
He just reached back like this and made a real, like, bad row. Like, it was just really, really, like, oh my gosh. And I thought right there and then on the way to West Fargo, I thought he was dying.
That trip to the vet cost over $700 and another adding up to almost $300 with a possible diagnosis of fading kitten syndrome, similar to failure to thrive in people.
I never thought he would wake up lethargic, no blood sugar, no blood pressure, and pretty much poke and prod in every little vein he has and going through torture just to try to keep him alive.
Gullickson says he bought Lenny off Facebook from a woman we told you about last week, Erin Chenot. She told Gullickson it was a half Maine Coon kitten. It was healthy and came with shots, but Gullickson says she didn't provide any proof.
Just looking at this poor little guy, it'll break your heart thinking wherever his siblings are, they're probably going through something worse.
He picked Lenny up at this apartment building on Prairie Woods Circle in Fargo, and a man claiming to be Aaron's brother brought the cat out to the parking lot. Gullickson says when he reached out to Chenot saying Lenny was sick, she didn't offer to help, just tried to sell him another cat. And now Gullickson says the woman blocked him on Facebook. He urges you to think twice before buying an animal on Facebook.
God forbid another person goes through exactly what I went through. You
know, 8 weeks.
Told the little guy when I got him because he was in a little bit of rough shape. I was like, I don't care if you're a little rat cat. I was like, you're my cat now, you know. So I just told him that no matter what happens, we're kind of in it together.
Bailey Hurley, Valley News Live.
We reached out to police and animal control. They say they're no longer investigating this case. In a statement, they said the actions of the seller may have been unethical, but not criminal. It isn't against the law to resell animals. Experts want to remind you that it's against Facebook's terms of service to buy and sell pets on the site. It's better to do your research on breeders in the area or adopt from Homeward Animal Shelter or Cat's Cradle.
One person suffered minor injuries after a garage went up in flames in Moorhead. Emergency crews responded to the home in the 2900 block of 29th Avenue Circle South. Firefighters quickly put the flames out. Officials say the homeowner was hurt but was not taken to a hospital. The garage was a total loss, but there was no damage, we're told, to the rest of the house. There's no word yet on what caused the fire.
Another decent day in the weather. Temps climbing this afternoon, making it a great night to fire up the grill. Hutch is at the Cashwise Backyard Barbecue. Hutch, how nice is it out there?
I got to tell you, it's pretty good. And we have Bryson here. He's cleaned his plate completely, and conditions are real nice outside. We have a high cloudiness over us right now, keeping the 80s feeling a lot more comfortable outdoors right now. Taking a look at temperatures, it's sizzling today up in the Northern Valley where we reached the mid-80s. Right now, still 84 in Thief River Falls and Roseau, 79 in Fergus Falls and Alexandria. A few more high clouds down in the south than up north. One of the reasons you're warmer there for today. Here is a look at your planner for this evening. Temperatures will stay in the 80s for the next couple of hours and slip into the 70s. It looks like we'll be in the 70s for most of the evening. And then as we approach and go beyond sunset, we'll be in the 60s. Likewise, Grand Forks, a lot of 70s there tonight with wonderful conditions. And we're here with this week's winner of the Cashwise Backyard Barbecue. Richard, tell me a little bit about where you signed up to win.
In Fargo.
In Fargo at the Cashwise. And how was everything tasting? Was it up to standards?
Hey, it looked beautiful. The first thing I ever won in my life.
That's awesome, man. You got a beautiful family here. Who's this guy right here? Do you know him?
My grandson.
Great-grandson. What's your name, young man?
Great-grandson.
Bryson.
Bryson was, did you have hot dog or steak?
Steak.
All right, steak. Give me five. Tell me how it was.
Good.
All right, very good. Well, everybody has a thumbs up out here right now. Congratulations, Richard, on winning this week, and thanks for your hospitality out here. We're having a good time. We'll check back in with your forecast for the rest of your work week and the weekend ahead coming up here in just a few moments.
Sounds good. Thanks, Hutch.
Cass County prosecutors believe a man accused in a deadly bar fight outside a Fargo bar will be sentenced to a year and a half worth of jail time. The sentencing for Darren Patterson has been set for August 16th. Last week, Patterson pleaded guilty to negligent homicide and aggravated assault. He was originally charged with manslaughter and two other assault charges. Authorities claim Patterson beat up three men, including Jamie Grant, outside the Hodo Bar on May 27th of last year. Grant died the next month.
A man is behind bars tonight after police say he crashed through a fence and hit a house in South Fargo and then tried to run away. 24-year-old Damian Troy of Fargo was heading south on Wheatland Drive before he left the road and then hit the house. No one in the home was injured. A passenger was hurt in the crash but was expected to be okay. Troy is facing multiple charges, including reckless endangerment and DUI.
No one was hurt after a vehicle crashed into a hotel in Jamestown. Last night, someone called authorities about a big hole in the Comfort Inn and Suites. The driver, Cheryl Cohen from Illinois, was cited. However, it's unknown at this time what her exact citation was.
What national issues are most important to you as a voter? That was one of the questions asked in an exclusive statewide poll by Valley News Live and Mason-Dixon Polling. 625 likely voters in North Dakota were interviewed by phone for the poll. It was conducted just last week from June 13th through the 15th. There's a 4% margin of error. On the question of issues most important to you, no surprise here, with the economy and jobs topping all others with 21%. Healthcare right behind at 19%, immigration at 11%. Gun rights and gun control standing at 10%, national security, terrorism, and foreign policy, 9%, and taxes, government spending, and the national debt at 8%. Other issues on the list included U.S. trade policy and tariffs, social issues such as same-sex marriage and abortion, and Russian collusion, removing Trump from office. Here's another question. Do you feel things in the country are on the right track or the wrong track? A solid majority statewide at 58% feel we're on the right track, 26% wrong track. When you look closer at Fargo and Cass County compared to eastern North Dakota, in the metro it's close, 48% to 45%. In eastern North Dakota, 50% feel we're on the right track, 27% wrong track. And look at the larger percentage, not sure, that's 23%. Our last question, do you feel things in North Dakota are on the right track or wrong track? Statewide, overwhelmingly right track, 69% to 18%. Similar percentages can be found when you look at the Fargo, Cass County, and eastern North Dakota. Now, if you want to see these numbers again, as well as the numbers for the U.S. Senate race, U.S. House race, and prominent statewide races, we've posted them on our website, valleynewslive.com.
It may be warm outside, but that doesn't mean it's too early to start thinking about the holidays. The Christmas Gift Program in Fargo hosted the annual event, Gift Burgers on the Plaza, today, just outside the Fargo Civic Center. For just $5, people filled up on as many burgers, chips, and drinks as they wanted. All proceeds from the event are going to the Christmas Gift Program, which gives Christmas presents to needy families every year during the holiday season. Program President Dan Michaels says he's impressed with how many people came to the event, despite the construction in town.
It's been a great turnout. Everybody has just been great, from our workers to everybody who came downtown to have a burger today, fire department, civic center. It's just been great.
The Christmas Gift Program has raised over $1.5 million over the past 28 years and has helped over 1,000 families.
Everybody's grilling but us.
Yeah, I know. We better get on it.
Later on Valley News Live at 6, some good advice for those of you wanting to get the most out of your homegrown gardens.
Up next, sell-by dates and what they mean for the meat in your freezers.